let's take a look at the scissor crunch, otherwise known as a straight-legged bicycle crunch. So Susan's gonna get herself set up, hands behind the head, legs are alternating, and there we go. You'll notice that she is always maintaining a lift of her shoulders off the ground. She's always maintaining a little spinal flexion. That's a really good thing. That makes us a heck of a lot more valuable to us. Smooth and controlled, and then relax for 1 second. Now, one thing that I know about Susan is that she has really good control of her hamstrings, which means that she can get to a straight leg position and go through that. I myself could not. I would need to bend my knees by about 30 degrees. So can we do just two more per side with a little bit of knee bent? There we go. And what's important here is that she's keeping the knees relatively static. She's not straightening and then bending them again. She's just changing the thought process from being about keeping the leg as straight as possible to allowing that little bit of knee bend so that there's less tension on the low back and it is easier for the abs to do what they're supposed to do. Really tight hamstrings will actually pull your pelvis and your low back into bad positions. So it is worth dealing with tight hamstrings via smart mobility work. But when you're in this position, if you find that you cannot maintain a straight leg, don't force it. Get it as straight as you can and then go through. Once again, those are our straight leg bicycles, otherwise known as scissor crunches. Scissor crunches?
Yeah.
Great.